Hey guys, welcome to Manoeuvre Education. This is Aditi Ray and today we will see about the examination NCHMCT JEE 2019, that is the National Council for Hotel Management and Catering Technology Joint Entrance Examination, that is supposed to be held on 27th of April 2019. I hope you are very aware of the date, that is 27th of April 2019. In this examination, 30 questions out of the 200 questions will be dedicated to your GK and current affairs section. So it is very important that you prepare for this section very well and very accurately. Now, another thing that you need to keep in your mind is that there is a negative of 1/4 marking for all the wrong questions that you attempt in this examination. Therefore, that makes it even more important for you to prepare for GK and current affairs section very well. All right. Now, what are the topics that you can focus on in your GK and current affairs section, and how you should be preparing for all these things, I will be talking about in a few minutes. So the first thing that you need to study, you need to have a basic good grasp of, is the history and geography of India. Now, when I say the history of India, they expect that you should be knowing the basic history, like the Indian freedom struggle, the British India. Alright, you need to have a basic understanding of the history. Now, when I say geography, geography plays a very important role. By geography, you should know the location of the states, their capitals, alright, the boundary of the Indian states when it comes to national boundaries and their international boundaries. Alright, next thing you need to study is the Indian polity. You need to have a good grasp of the Indian polity as well. Next topic comes the important government schemes. Now they can ask you some important government schemes with respect to tourism. Next comes the days and dates. These are very factual, so you will have to put in more efforts to remember the days and dates. Alright, so for example, they can ask you the yoga day, the International Yoga Day. So the International Yoga Day is on celebrated on 21st of June every year. So you need to remember days and dates like these. Next comes the books and authors. So all the important books and authors, the recent ones and the more important ones. You need to be aware of all these things. Next comes the sports and tournaments. So you need to be aware of all the sports and tournaments that have happened recently and all the winners. In science and technology, you need to be aware of all the recent space related science and technology. Alright, especially the works of ISRO. These play a major part of your GK section. Next comes the international organizations. By international organization, I mean the United Nations, World Bank, International Monetary Fund, World Economic Forum, etc. So you need to be aware of the headquarters of these international bodies, the reports or indexes that these publish, all right, and the sub bodies of United Nations as well. So these are the things that you need to keep in your mind when it comes to international organizations. Next comes the conglomerate mergers and their subsidiaries. Now these will be extremely current affair oriented. When I talk about mergers, I mean something like recently Vodafone and Idea were merged together. Alright, so these kind of news you need to keep in your mind when it comes to conglomerate mergers and their subsidiaries. Next comes the Indian culture and tourism. This will be a prime focus. So when it comes to Indian culture, they can ask you the dance forms and the region that it belongs to. Alright, they can ask you like Kathak belongs to which region of India. So it belongs to the north of India. Kathakali, Bharatanatyam, etc. So you need to be aware of the dance forms, the folk dances, the folk culture, etc. And when I talk about tourism, you need to be aware of the Government of India's tourism program. Alright. Next comes current affairs. You need to focus on last 1 year's current affairs minimum that I'm talking about. So you need to be very well aware of last 1 year's current affairs and the miscellaneous section. Moving ahead, let us talk about a very important festival called the Hornbill Festival. The Hornbill Festival is a part of the Nagaland state. It is celebrated on 1st to 7th of December every year. Alright, so this festival belongs to the state of Nagaland. Hornbill Festival was established on 1st December 1963 and was inaugurated by the then president, Dr. S. Radhakrishnan. It is one of the biggest indigenous festivals of our country. The festival pays tribute to hornbill. Now, hornbill is the name of a bird. All right, I'll show you the bird in the next slide. So the festival pays tribute to hornbill, the most admired and revered bird for the Nagas, for its qualities of alertness and grandeur. It is also called as the Festival of Festivals in Nagaland. As you can see, this is part of, this picture is a part of the Hornbill Festival. Moving ahead, so the Hornbill Festival provides a colorful mixture of dance, performance, craft, parades, games, sports, food fairs and religious ceremonies. Now here, as you can see, this is the hornbill bird that I was talking about. All right, this is the hornbill bird. It exposes both the culture and traditions of tribal people and reinforces Nagaland's identity as a unique state in India's federal union. Over the years, the festival has become a unique platform for tourists. This is why it is very important for you to witness the cultural diversity, not only of the Nagas, but also of the other seven sisters of the Northeast region. Now this great hornbill, the bird, is also happens to be a state bird of two states, that is Arunachal Pradesh and Kerala. Interestingly, even though this hornbill festival happens in Nagaland, hornbill is not the state bird of Nagaland. All right, it is not the state bird of Nagaland. Hornbill happens to us to be the state bird of Arunachal Pradesh and Kerala. All right, so I hope you have got the idea how to go about your with your GK and current affairs section. You have to keep a very good balance with your static and current affairs portion and give more weightage to topics with corporate and tourism point of view. If you are a Mumbai based student, you can contact us at our Borivali Center at this number 907-6424-208. You can also contact us at our Dadar Center at this number 7304-366-82. If you are not a Mumbai based student, you can contact our online team at this number 8828-581455. Or you can also visit us at our website, that is maneuveredu.com. For more videos, please hit the subscribe button. Also, don't forget to like the video and do share the video with your friends on WhatsApp, Facebook and other social medias. All the best for your upcoming examinations. Have a good day. Thank you.